Today, we will discuss between semantic analyzer. Remember, semantic analyzer comes after the syntax analyzer in the compiler code generation and the intermediate code generation abstract syntax tree. So, I have covered it in my earlier class. Postfix notation that we already covered in data structure classes also. And there is another 3AC or it is a three address code. Sometimes it is written as 3AC, or in some books it's a TAC, T for 3, quadruple. How to maintain the three address code in which data structure? It generally quadruple or maybe triple. Quadruple is more efficient. And the syntax directed definition and translation. That means every rule, syntax rule, it has to have some syntax directed definition and translation rule also. Then all the variable, whether it can be synthesized attribute or inherited attribute or L attributes, this term will define today. The first stage is we already covered the lexical analysis. It is done by a series of tokens and it is the syntax analyzer. Mostly we have agreed it should be preferably LR1 or LALR1 bottom up parsing, in some cases LL1 also. Syntax analysis is done, but output of the syntax analysis not only, but we always say whether it is accept or not accept, but whether it is accepted, then output should also contain a tree, and that tree is though generally called a syntax tree, but it should be, I have already called it as abstract syntax tree notation, AST notation, which is much more compact than syntax tree. And semantic analysis, lot of things like whether out of array bound checking, or you are putting some floating point value which is supposed to be an integer, all these things has been checked by the semantics analyzer. And then the intermediate code generation comes, because intermediate code generation, it is always better that a same source language may be run on different machines. So there is always an intermediate code generator, which then thus ultimately the target machine, there is another code generation. The intermediate code you can more much more efficient on that platform. We'll come to that. Yeah, so this is it. Let's go. Yeah, so this is, here we are, the semantic analysis and the intermediate code generation, or intermediate representation. The intermediate represent, how to represent, there is one is abstract syntax tree, one of these postfix notation, we'll come to that. We are here basically the syntax analyzer and the intermediate code generation. Abstract syntax tree, like this is a syntax tree, we have seen the lot of redundant information is not required. It's operation, this operation goes to the node values, and the variables comes to the this space, the leaf. So this is a abstract syntax tree notation, and it is very, this way it has been here we can see that this is the static type checker. See, in some code like Java and C, lot of things can be checked by static type checker, but cannot be in Python, because Python, you know that it is runtime, it's check. Anyway, this is the intermediate code. Intermediate code, this thing will be on various virtual machines, maybe Java virtual machines and Python virtual machine, or depends on many platform. So intermediate code is one code which can be optimized independent of your target computer, and that's it. These are the different forms, and some of the language use all the forms. Like abstract syntax tree is a must, that when the syntax analysis is done, the output should be abstract syntax tree. Postfix notation is also is used. You know that we generally understand infix notation better, but computer understand postfix notation better. But it's definitely a tree, any binary tree, the root reached at the last visiting the child, the postfix notation, basically a linearized form of a syntax tree or abstract syntax tree. The postfix is very useful, and tree address code, basically if we have many variables, we'll put it to three at a time, operand 1, operand 2, and result, and operation, the operand 1 and operand 2 and result, which actually these are the three address codes. Generally, these address may be a pointer address. A syntax tree defines actual hierarchical structure source program. Another thing is directed acyclic graph. We see there's some kind of computation is repeated here. So the compiler will detect by directed acyclic graph is there's a duplication of effort. So we'll replace it. Postfix notation, I have told, this is a linearized representation, excellent linearized representation in a of a syntax tree. Parse tree, abstract syntax tree like this, we have two leaf nodes, and this is the operation, this is taken care of, and then ultimately this is. Advantage is it's a postfix form, easy to evaluate, source code can be reconstructed, it is sometimes, it can be debugging also, it's easier. Now the syntax directed definition, what is syntax is a definition, we said every attributes are variable have some definition, and every context CFG rule has some semantic notation, semantic rule also, not only syntax rule, every CFG rule with the semantic rules. So, and how the these variables mostly are synthesized variables. Synthesized means they take up the value from bottom up, from the child, the parent get the values, or sometimes inherited. Inherited means it will come from parent or by the siblings, not from the child. And another kind of attribute will come, that is an L attribute, that is it is from the only from the it can be synthesized also from the child also, and from parent also, and from left side of single, like you can say that is our senior brothers or sister sibling, not from right. So these are called L attributed, but mostly synthesized attributed and inherited, and another is L attributed, which is mix of synthesized plus inherited from parent and for the left siblings. And every context free grammar will have some all these rules that is defined both syntax directed definition and syntax directed translation. Syntax directed definition like a definition sort of thing, and translation actual how it will occur, these are the things are there. Let's see. Yeah, syntax, both are these there, syntax directed definitions and translation scheme, how it is actually will be translated, it is there for, this is called all semantic rules. Where you are in the program, program is syntactically correct, then now it is checking the operations of whether numbers are quoted correctly, array or array not out, array out of bound, or everything is casting properly. So these things are checked at this semantic analysis, that the meaning of the program is okay or not. That is, I told, syntax related definition, more readable, both are used and useful for specification, and syntax related translation is productions with semantic action, more efficient, useful for implementation. Inherited and synthesized attribute, I have already told, a synthesized attribute of a non-terminal at a parse tree defined from the child, bottom-up approach. An inherited approach is terminal at a parse tree defined by the parent. In parent, in itself, or in siblings. Remember, another attribute will come, that is in parent, in itself, and left side of the sibling, that is called L attribute. S attribute is a synthesized attribute. So this is the synthesized attribute, and this is the L attribute. Definitely L is a superset, is a bigger set, because L attribute means it takes care of the synthesized attribute also. Yeah, role of intermediate IIR, interpreted representation. because X is a glue between front end and back end. You know the compiler has two stages, one is front end and back end. Front end in the all the analysis portion, and then the intermediate code generation. And otherwise, you have to give M star in configuration, and we can try to make it M plus N. So if there are M different N different hardware, M different front end, so instead of M star N, we go for M plus N and enable machine independent operation, that is vital. Different, these are the things, intermediate, how their properties, high level, more close to source language, low level, assembly language level. So here we have already covered abstract syntax tree is way we generally this intermediate representation we are carrying. Another is directed acyclic graph. Directed acyclic graph, I will come to that. Directed acyclic graphs, whenever abstract syntax tree we think certain expressions are repeatedly calculated, then we replace by this. Maybe your in syntax tree every node has a only one parent, but the directed acyclic graph may have another root node can be have another parent also, so that we can avoid the same calculation again and again. So that will cover, and linearly we know the postfix is one, three address code, it is a very traditional, and the hybrid approach depends on language to language and all these things, and compiler who are generating the compiler. Three address codes is a traditional one, that is a argument one, the first operand, argument second operand, and result is destination, and operation is there. And these representation are quadruples. These all are we'll see in the next slide. Yes, this is, you can see here, that is say B minus C calculation here by directed acyclic graph. We are not computing here in this portion. We are computing this same B minus C calculation to here. So this is a conversion from abstract syntax tree to directed acyclic graph. In abstract syntax tree, this is not allowed, but in directed acyclic graph, this B minus C, I can put it there itself. And this is a faster operation and efficient, definitely. And this is the expression. And this is the representative three address code. This is the same thing is represented like this is unary operation. I put it like this, a temporary variable 1 minus C. So this is the thing I have to put it. And this is again, yeah, this is a minus C, and this one is 3 address code, and this is the quadruples. How to replace? This is a, this represents a quadruples, triples. Quadruples is preferable. Quadruple you can, triple you cannot optimize, and there's indirect triples. We'll come to that. So this is directed acyclic graph. Yes, this is three address code. Quadruples is the preferred way. This is syntax tree or abstract syntax tree, intermediate code and machine independent codes, and some machine and the three address code implemented in quadruples. The three address code is implemented generally in quadruples, like operand 1, operand 2, result and operation is a quadruple, and quadruple are close to machine instruction, and they are not actual machine instruction. Now this will be converted to actual code later. Some programming languages have well defined intermediate language like Java, Prolog. Here, say this is say left hand side you can see a abstract syntax tree, and right hand side is a directed acyclic graph like B minus C computation. I am using it here, so it can have like this. Reduces advantage, reduces, that is the advantage of directed. So these are the tools used by the this phase, intermediate code generation. I have told three address code, either it's known by TAC or TAC. It is very easy. Like three address code here, we have like this. This is our expression. So we start from this place. We first like a T1 is equal to 2 star Y. This is a three address. Sometimes three address is the maximum. It can be two address also. It unary, it can be. So then the T2 is X minus T1. And remember this, even the they generate, the compiler generate is T1, T2 that way. Like whenever they are creating new, they are automatically creating this numbered temporary variable T for temporary. So like ultimately J is equal to T2. So easy to understand, names of iterative values. This is done. This is way allows various kinds of operation. You can do assignment, you can have logical, all these things can be branches, all can be expressed by three address code. These are his examples, like the right left hand side, this is the expression. We first calculate for B minus C is equal to T1, then T2, T3, T4, rightly you get it here. Same is here, is a with the go to, we implemented this by T1 is less than L2, S1. Same expression is implemented here. Some while loop also, we have done it here. Quadruples instructions can be ordered. Like remember this intermediate representation, all the tools have been taken by three address code, directed acyclic graph, to make it more compact, and the postfix, all are generally used. And three address codes are implemented by quadruples, and it can be done by triples, either or, it depends. The quadruples give better, but it takes maybe more space. Same thing. Triples instruction cannot be reordered easily, while quadruple it can be. It can be two address code also, similar like our assembly language. These are other types. One address code. Typical stack based computers are one address codes, with everything happening at the top of the stack, that is a single address. Thank you for being here.